So, let's start with the councils. So this has no question, it could be of single phase transformer. Very basic idea. Okay, then basic definition is the, it's a static device, right? The static device. Okay, capable of transforming. Voltage means AC voltage. Okay, so this is the basic definition of a transformer. So it's a static device. Static device means there is no moving part, that, you know, that's the main of this. No moving part. Okay, that's why static device capable of transforming voltage from one level to another level. So this level, depending upon the level of voltage, they can, you know, boost or block. They are normally classified into two types, as we studied the, you know, earlier, step up transformers and, you know, step down transformers. So if I am going to mention another, you know, following, so let V1 is the input voltage, it's also called primary voltage, and V2, the output voltage. Output in the sense it is the secondary voltage. Then N1 is the number of coils in the primary, and N2 number of turns or coils in the secondary. Right? Then we can say that in the case of a step up transformer. You can see that normally V2, right, is more than V1. V2 means the secondary voltage is more than primary voltage. In the same manner, step down transformer, V1 is greater than V2. Okay? And there are some relations, you know, that is, you know, which connects between the transformer voltage and the, what do you call, the turns. That is V1 by V2 is equal to N1 by N2. Okay? This is the basic relation. V1 by V2 is equal to N1 by N2. This works. So here you can see, you know, two type of transformers, right? The first model is the quarter transformer. Second model is the shell type transformer. This is called a shell type transformer. It's like a quarter transformer. So normally for the low LV, you know, LV like, you know, transformers, they, you know, step down transformers for, you know, a household, you know, different equipment or something, you normally go for what you call the shell type transformer. So means what, it's like a shell. Well, the coil is already inside. Now, if you have got an inner link, in the inner link, the coils are located, right? And what you can see or what you can touch is the outer part of the, you know, core, right? And the coil is inside. Whereas in the case of quarter transformers, now high rated, high power transformers, normally this is made up of in the form of a particular core where the coils are located in the outer periphery and the middle is empty. So, you you can see and touch the what you call the coils directly. But here is, so this is an advantage, is it? Then we are going to, you know, see the details in the machine design, right? What are the advantages of core type over the shell types and so on. But which one is easy to implement or to design or to fabricate? Manufacturing wise, you know, I mean fabrication wise, this is much more easy, you know, because you can make a coil here. But this one, it is hard actually, you know, to make it. Okay, so that's some practical difficulties there for fabricating, you know, such transformers. So let's see what is the MOF equation of transformer. So again, we are making the following assumptions. Let N1 be the primary coils, number of primary coils, N2 be the secondary coils, in numbers, you know, number of coils, V1 be the primary voltage, V2 is the secondary voltage, then phi m, this is something new actually, you know, phi is the flux, flux and flux in the core of the transformer, and phi m is the maximum flux, maximum flux in the core. Okay, F is the frequency of the primary supply, supply voltage, T is the time period, okay, so that's, I think we can add later. I think what you can do right here, instead of saying V1, we are going to say E1 and E2. Because what we mean E1 and E2? Yeah, I think it will give V1 and E2 because again this will be confusion. So for the time being, we are keeping as V1, V2. I think, you know, then in the future, you know, we'll change it. Because there is a difference between the terminal voltage and induced voltage, okay? So what we can try to understand is, in the case of primary, we are applying voltage, right? AC voltage. So I am going to apply the primary voltage, okay? Suppose it will be in the sinusoidal signal. We can see that the voltages keep changing, right? And it reaches maximum value here, right? And such a flux if you are going to apply to the primary, the corresponding flux is also in the form of the sinusoidal flux, right? Because this flux is produced by the supply voltage. So, therefore, the flux can also get, take the same shape of the input voltage. So, this is the flux and the time. So, what you can see that after some time, it reaches the maximum flux, right? The maximum flux is already we defined phi m. So, this is called phi m here. The total time period of one cycle, normally we call this, we are going to refer as t, right? If it is t, then how much will be this? It will be T over 2, correct? How much will be this? T over 4, correct? As you can see that in T by 4 time, right? The time of T by 4 or at T by 4, in an instant, what happened? A flux of?
Maximum
flux will be, you know, achieved, correct? So we can say that phi m is, right? Phi m occurs at T by 4 seconds, correct? Not. So you want to know what is the rate of change, because now as we have seen, the voltage induced in a coil, voltage induced in a coil, as per the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, it is proportional to what you call rate of change of flux, correct? What is rate of change of flux? Flux with respect to time. So this, the voltage induced in a coil is proportional to, correct? It's proportional to rate of change of flux. So I can say that the voltage is proportional to, right?
What?
Phi m. Because what is rate of change? Rate of change is nothing but change of phi with respect to time. Even I can say equal, you know. Later on we can, you know, add the, you know, the remaining what you call approximation terms. Okay, this is equal to change in flux is what? Phi m, correct? The maximum flux. Because it's happened maximum at that instant, divided by the corresponding time is what? T by 4. Right? So what is the relationship between T and F? F is the frequency, right? Frequency is equal to 1 over T. Right? Or T is equal to what? 1 over F. Because T is in seconds, whereas frequency is in hertz, correct? So what I can do, instead of T, I can substitute what? 1 divided by 4f, correct? Because this 4 is already there, the t become 1 by f, so this becomes 4f, right? It is like a by b divided by c by d. What's going to happen? This 4f will go up, then we'll have equation 4, 5 times f, yeah. So this is the first part, okay? We didn't reach the final equation, but we got the equation is 4, 5. Then this voltage, you know, it happened in a coil, okay? In a single coil. Correct? This is what they happen in a single coil. If there are n1 number of turns, you know, n1 number of coils, then the voltage induced in, sorry, coils in the primary, then the voltage induced. Okay, that's why, you know, when you say induced, this V1 become E1 actually, correct? Okay. So this is the primary voltage and V2 is the secondary voltage, which is available at the, you know, terminals. Mm. Whereas I'm going to say voltage induced. This voltage induced, I'm going to say E1, that is equal to 4FIM into N1. Okay, that much volts. What will be in the secondary? The same thing, except that this N2, it has become N2 here, correct? So this is the first part. Again, not yet done, we have to continue. Okay, this part. Okay, so this is the, you know, induced voltage we got. Now, in AC, normally we have maximum voltage, RMS voltage, right? These are the normal, you know, considerations, correct? You know, RMS voltage and the maximum voltage. And also there is something called average voltage. So in the case of pure DC, the average voltage will be 0, okay? And the point is that whatever we got it is, you know, the rate of change, it is average voltage, right? So what we want is, we want to calculate the RMS. So what is the relation between RMS by average? RMS by average is always equal to 1.11. This is also called form factor, okay? There is a concept, terminology called form factor. Form factor is something but RMS by average. So what do we have? The voltage which we got it is something but the average voltage. Right, but we are interested in RMS, because RMS is the effective voltage. Average is you know, you are taking over one cycle, right? But RMS is the effective voltage. So the effective voltage is always, you know, the real, you know, what you call the useful part of the voltage here. So in order to get RMS voltage, RMS primary voltage will be what? We have to multiply the term that we already have it, okay, which become what? 4.44 phi m into f into n volts, correct? Similarly, the RMS secondary voltage will be 4.44 phi m f into n2. So this is one of the very
important little equation. That is called the EMF equation of a transformer. Okay.